Electronic Arts is quite possibly the most controversial and divisive game development company in the world. On the one hand, producing microtransaction-fueled games with in-game gambling systems such as loot boxes and graphical gambling machine simulators, and on the other hand, helping to produce some of the greatest microtransaction-free games of all time, such as Dead Space, Mass Effect 2, and Dragon Age Inquisition. In the turbulent wake of many of its decisions in the past, there has been an onslaught of many amusing memes.
E3 EA $39.99 Beach Beach Unlock area for $99.
Yet EA can adapt, albeit sluggishly, and only after large amounts of pressure from consumers and sponsors such as Disney. In the case of Star Wars Battlefront 2, it took almost a year, but after much pressure, EA allowed DICE to largely negate the microtransactions present in the game and have since continued to support the game as it continues to grow and improve. Star Wars Battlefront 2 is now one of the best science fiction first-person shooters available, along with Titanfall 2. When it was announced that a new Star Wars game was being produced by EA and developed by Respawn, this reviewer certainly had reservations. Originally, Visceral Games had been working on a single-player story-driven Star Wars game with Amy Henning, the lead writer for the largely successful Uncharted series. This, though, had been cancelled by EA, the company that had also stated that players weren't interested in single-player games anymore. Respawn's track record was also in first-person shooter games that leaned heavily towards online multiplayer. What would this game actually turn out to be? Another microtransaction-fueled mess? As more details arose about the game, this reviewer also became very concerned about the approach to combat, as the developers began to divulge that it would be leaning heavily towards the type of melee combat present in games like Bloodborne and Neo. It just didn't seem to fit. Star Wars, after all, is a science fiction fantasy experience full of movement, explosions, and stormtroopers that constantly fire and hit everything other than what they are actually aiming at. Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order is, wait for it, exceptionally good. Yes, a single-player, microtransaction-free Star Wars game produced by Electronic Arts. Who would have thought it possible? Yet, here it is, alive and kicking, a breath of fresh air in an often dense cloud of disappointment. The game is stunningly beautiful to look at, and the faithful recreation of all things Star Wars mirrors the work that was put into Star Wars Battlefront 2 by DICE. The environmental detailing, lighting, shadows, use of color, effects, all masterfully created. What makes this even more impressive is that Respawn have somehow managed to make the Unreal Engine look like Frostbite. There are several imaginatively and contrasting semi-open world planet environments to explore, with new areas gradually being unlocked as you gain new powers along your travels. A large range of cosmetic collectibles are scattered around the various planets, some more easy to find and acquire than others. These are used to customize your lightsaber, clothing, companion, and chip, all of which could have easily been actual microtransaction purchases. The combat is a very light version of the gameplay that you will find in Neo, but because you have access to progressive force powers, it isn't as restrictive. Having said this though, this reviewer only played it on the normal setting, and even then, a player can't afford to be reckless, especially early on in the game. Helping take the edge off the combat is a unique save system. There are numerous save points throughout the areas to explore, and at these, a player is given a choice as to whether to save and continue, or to completely restore their health and force power. With the latter option though, all enemies are respawned. It is a great system, allowing players to make some tactical choices, as well as allowing them to gain experience points by re-engaging previously defeated enemies. An extremely well-crafted character-driven story by Aaron Contreras, Manny Hagopian, Matt Michnovitz, and Megan Fausti delivers a much more memorable experience than Star Wars The Last Jedi. Yes, you heard that correctly. This game has a better story than an actual Star Wars film. Stephen Barton and Gordy Harb have composed a wonderful original soundtrack that is completely in keeping with the great compositions of John Williams, but gives the game a unique identity within the Star Wars canon. Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order is a genuinely pleasant surprise. What the game director Stig Asmussen and Respawn have managed to create here has not only breathed new life into Star Wars, but is also one of the best games of recent years. Brilliant.